For the final time, four Kansas seniors take the floor at Allen Fieldhouse. A senior class with three Big 12 titles, closing in on number four. Senior night for Jeff Withey and the Kansas seniors at the Fieldhouse, they need. From Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, this is Big Monday presented by Bud Light as fourth-ranked Kansas closes out their home schedule against Texas Tech. Always a pleasure to be courtside at Allen Fieldhouse. Carter Blackburn with Stephen Bardo. Less than a month ago, Kansas was mired in a three-game losing streak. Bill Self was saying it was the worst Kansas team since when James Naismith began coaching here. Well, now it's March, Stephen, and Kansas is ranked number four in line for a number one seed.
You know, it was interesting because it looked as though the eight-year run for the Jayhawks in Big 12 country was going to end during that three-game losing streak, especially losing to TCU. That was probably the biggest upset of the season in college basketball. But these four seniors on this ball club really steadied the ship, got hot at the right time, and been playing their best basketball right now.
It is the last home game, meaning it is senior night, of course, in our one-on-one, the Kansas seniors included.
Yeah, they've been outstanding down the stretch, especially Elijah Johnson and his performance at Iowa State, but Jeff Withey, Kevin Young, and Travis Relaford have had an outstanding careers here at Kansas. And for Texas Tech, Jordan Tolbert hoping to continue the good vibes that he had against TCU. He averages over 20 points a game in three meetings against them, hoping to continue that string here.
Rest of the starting lineup joining Jordan Tolbert for Texas Tech. It's Hannah's Josh Gray, the freshman point guard, Jamal Williams, and Dayon Kravitz, the leading scorer. Jay Crockett comes off the bench for Texas Tech. And for the Kansas Jayhawks on senior night, it's Johnson, Relaford, Young, and Withey, joined by Travis Relaford, coming off a tremendous 36-point performance Saturday against West Virginia. Bill Self in his 10th season as the Kansas coach, 501 wins now in his college coaching career, including 162 here at Allen Fieldhouse, 8 conference titles, 8 home losses for Bill Self. Texas Tech, coached by Chris Walker. He is the interim head coach, took over when Billy Gillespie was let go in September, officially a resignation, and Chris Walker finally got a win on Saturday, snapping a 9-game losing streak with a win over TCU.
Yeah, he's been very positive in terms of his players staying positive through that 9-game losing streak. Each time we go to shoot around, you would notice that they were losing. It's a confident group.
Senior night for Kansas. And they started off with Johnson to Withey, attempted alley-oop. Kevin Young, one of those seniors, the first to score. So, Stephen, how in the world is Texas Tech, who's 3-13 in the Big 12, come in here on senior night and compete with fourth-ranked Kansas at Allen Fieldhouse?
They're going to try to run some faux motion or fake motion to take up some of the time in the shot clock, and then within a certain amount, go to look to drive.
Kravitz is fouled on
number 23.
The first possession. The foul's on Ben McLemore.
Texas Tech is not going to be able to run up and down the floor with Kansas, so they have to shorten the game up. And how do you do that? You take your time in each possession, try to take 25 to 30 seconds in each possession and shorten the game up as much as you possibly can.
First meeting between these two on January the 12th in Lubbock. Kansas won by 14. Dayon Kravitz walked.
Dayon Kravitz is going to be ready to play. Knowing that Jeff Withey, not only one of the premier big men in the Big 12, but premier big men in the nation. The nation's leading shot blocker, so he's going to try to test his mettle against Withey. Kansas is really patient in the half-court set, typically.
That's a kick ball.
You see the Jayhawks in trouble, Carter. They're jacking up threes early in the possession. They like to swing the ball from side to side, allowing their high-low offense to get easy looks for Withy in the post area.
Johnson into the paint with a spin and a 4-0 start for KU.
Well, the spin cycle's on early in the game. Elijah Johnson, that's been the biggest difference, I think, in his play down the stretch. A lot of people look to his three-point shooting, but it's his ability to go off the bounce and create pressure on drives like that that has really elevated his game.
Freshman point guard Gray nearly turns it over. 9 to shoot. Hand is to the floor. 4 to shoot. Tech keeps it with only 4 on the shot clock.
Dusty Hanna's taking a little bit of contact there. Tech is going to have to get a set play here quickly. Get a shot off.
Three seconds to shoot. Young picks it up. McLemore fouled on the way to the hoop. Worst case scenario for Texas Tech.
Yeah, they're just active hands and got 4 seniors on the floor and possibly the best 2 guard in the nation in Kansas right now. They're a motivated group to jump on Texas Tech quick.
Ben McLemore off a 36-point performance on Saturday. That set the new Kansas freshman scoring record, surpassing Danny Manning's 35, which he had against Oklahoma State in 1985. When the Cowboys had a guy by the name of Bill Self on the floor when Danny Manning went for 35.
I'm sure Bill can recount almost every bucket Danny hit on him.
Speaking of Danny Manning, Tulsa with a big come-from-behind win this weekend.
Yeah, Danny Manning's going to get that turned around. And like any player, or any coach, rather, he's got to get his type of players that best suit his system.
Withy nearly gets the block. Bothered the shot by Kravich.
Hands with the secondary fast break action. Just blend right into their half-court offense off of that.
Withy. A 7-0 start for Jeff Withy and the Jayhawks on senior night. Timeout, Texas Tech. And speaking of Danny Manning, there he is, the now head coach at Tulsa, who had a big hand in recruiting these seniors to Kansas and whose son Evan Manning is now a Jayhawk.
Yeah, Danny Manning, I had the pleasure, or maybe not pleasure, of trying to guard him on a number of occasions and doing an outstanding job, but he's a better human being. He and his father I got to know very well, and I'm really happy that Danny has the opportunity that he has at Tulsa.
Daughter Taylor is a senior here at Kansas. That's quite a statement saying Danny Manning's a better person than he is a basketball player, because he was an unbelievable basketball player.
Just salt of the earth type of guy, and he wouldn't have been on Bill Self's staff if anything other than just a solid guy and a tremendous role model for all the great players that have come through Kansas while he was on the staff, and someone to definitely look up to.
Now the head coach at Tulsa. Tulsa hosts the Conference USA tournament next week. Gray runner, finally something goes in the hoop for Texas Tech.
It's interesting, Chris Walker, the interim head coach of Texas Tech, wanting his guys to be confident and slow down the offense, but you also got to let guys go. If they have an opportunity, like Gray, he's an explosive guard in terms of getting in the paint area.
We've not yet seen Tech's leading scorer, Jay Crockett, who comes off the bench. He's headed to the scorer's table now. Kravich.
Withy doesn't get enough credit. We don't have a statistic in the game of college basketball called changed shots, but he'd have as many, if not more, than he does block shots.
Young fouled by Jordan Tolbert off a good look from McLemore.
Ben McLemore, he's just getting better every game, adding something to his repertoire. He was falling off balance. One-hand shovel pass to Kevin Young.
So the first on Tolbert since Kevin Young, the senior from Paris, California, spent his first couple of years at Loyola Marymount. Saturday against West Virginia won over 1,000 career points scored between Loyola Marymount and Kansas.
Yeah, he's had an outstanding 2 years here. And one thing Bill Self talked about is a guy that could be a coach in terms of his cerebral approach to the game. Extremely knowledgeable, goes in and watches film, but you know, he's a guy that during this stretch run that Kansas has righted the ship, he's been a physical presence. And if you look at him, you would think anything but that's the senioritis that takes place with guys coming down the stretch in their career.
Kansas has won six straight since the three-game losing streak. First points for Jordan Tolbert with Texas Tech.
That's textbook action right there. Tolbert, when you have a shot block, you go right through their chin or their nose. You don't give them any space to go up and contest your shot. Good job by Tolbert, going strong.
McLemore somehow gets to the hoop.
That's just too easy. There were five bodies in there at the time, and he just almost looked like he was in slow motion. That's what the great ones do. They make it look easy.
This is Crockett, Tech's leading scorer, number 30. Jay Crockett.
Despite the miss, that's good action by Texas Tech. A little pick and pop with he and Dusty Hannah. You got to respect Hannah's ability to shoot the three.
Elijah Johnson. Crockett rips the rebound. Leading score and rebounder for Tech. Jamal Williams Jr. hits a baseline, Jay.
Bill Self will give up that shot any day of the week. Kansas got back defensively. They fanned out, contested the shot. That's just better offense at time for Tech.
Into Withy. Fouled on the way up by Crockett. Hot start for Kansas on senior night. ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go.
Wednesday, it's Bull Spurs at 9 on ESPN.
Wednesday night on ESPNU, big one in the Big 12 as Oklahoma State takes on Iowa State at 7 Eastern, then Connecticut versus South Florida at 9 Eastern. Critical game for Iowa State against the Cowboys.
Yeah, they're last four in according to Lenardi, and you know that's a thing that could go either way without them playing. And so you look at Iowa State, Oklahoma State at their place, they still have they have to go to West Virginia, their last regular season game. So they have a tough road to hoe here down the stretch. And Bob Huggins' group, they may not have a 500 record, but they're going to be tough at home against Iowa State.
It is senior night here at Allen Fieldhouse with a group of four seniors who have won the Big 12 title every year. So that would be two for Kevin Young. That would be four for Elijah Johnson. Jeff Withy, four Big 12 titles. And officially, Travis Relaford has five because he redshirted a year. So you go five for five. That's impressive. Part of the run of eight straight Big 12 titles. And the senior class is closing in on potentially a ninth straight Big 12 title for Kansas.
They really have. And if you're going to have a tiebreaker in the situation, let's say everything stays the same, Kansas beat Kansas State twice this year. So in all actuality, they would be the outright champs to me. But, you know, I don't make the rules. I just call games.
Well, any way you slice it, been an impressive run for these seniors. And they each have their own stories, including a guy like Jeff Withy. I know one former Pac-12 coach said he would never play for Kansas, never start for the Jayhawks. And Jeff Withy has proven him and everyone else wrong.
Well, that's the thing when you're dealing with 18 to 22-year-olds, there's so much potential in all these student-athletes, and you don't know what they have in their chest, meaning what they have in their heart. and if they're willing to work. And Jeff Whitney put in the work, and the results speak for themselves.
3 seconds to shoot for Tech. Bravich. That's a shot clock violation. Didn't touch the rim. And Jeff Whitney is part of senior night. Parents Debbie and Mike here to root on their son Jeff, who earned his degree in December in American Studies. Quite a journey for Jeff Whitney, who committed to Louisville, then decided on Arizona when that program was really in turmoil. Ended up coming to Kansas, San Diego, California, and he has made his mark here with the Jayhawks.
He has made his mark. He's a beneficiary of Thomas Robinson and the Morris twins, and playing against those guys in practice and getting beaten and working with their strength staff to get stronger. And, you know, Bill Self knows some things about Whitney that his parents don't know.
That's how that when you have the test from a coach, and we have the pleasure really to come watch Bill Self's practices, you will get tougher.
Oh yeah, you'll get tougher. And his parents, and we're looking at them right now, Bill Self has seen things in Jeff Whitney that his parents don't know about. You know, there's some times when things were tough and Jeff wouldn't call home, he called Bill Self. And that's why when you saw Bill hug the seniors coming out here, he's fighting back tears as much as the players are, because he's seen them come in wet behind the ears and they're hopefully leaving his men.
And Jeff did tell us earlier today he was nervous about senior night.
Yeah, because there's a lot of emotion. You don't know what to expect. Every player handles it differently. I mean, I let it go because it was very emotional to have your parents walk out on the floor with you. You know, you play with a certain level of emotion because it's your last time out. You have to be very careful to keep it in check, but Kansas looks like they're on a very good start thus far.
Travis Relaford headed to the free throw line. The way Kansas does their senior night, they recognize the seniors before the game, and then after the game concludes, then those seniors come out and have a chance to address the crowd. That's Travis Relaford's mother, Vanita. She has a younger son, Trevor, who's at Alabama, so she will have two senior nights with Travis and Trevor.
Think of the pride that she has. Two young men at this level playing two prestigious programs, seeing their maturity.
And those senior night ceremonies we mentioned here at Allen Fieldhouse, when we're done here on ESPNU, you can watch the senior night ceremony live on ESPN3. Relaford follows his free throw miss. It will be Tech ball.
Yeah, Relaford doesn't like the call, but a lot of times officials will just give it the other way instead of making a foul call. But I don't know. That's a tough one. That's why the officials are real good, and I'm sitting over here.
Tolbert righted Whitney to draw the foul.
If I'm Texas Tech, I go to Jordan Tolbert. I mean, he's been aggressive towards Whitney, not backing off an inch. Drew the foul that time, was able to go through him and finish his first opportunity. Doing well, establishing himself on the block early.
Jordan Tolbert got 22 in the win over TCU on Saturday. He always plays well against TCU. Oh, by the way, he is from Fort Worth, Texas,
of course,
the hometown of TCU.
Yeah, you find motivations a lot of different places. And he understands the Horned Frogs, and growing up watching them, he wants to come back home and show what he's been able to accomplish.
Nadir Tharp into the game for Kansas, along with Perry Ellis. Ellis stripped. Fight for the loose ball. Tie up. Possession to Texas Tech.
Todrick Gotcher had a chance to get that loose ball, and he took off down the floor, expecting his teammate to do the dirty work. You have to secure the basketball before you can get any opportunities. Texas Tech fortunate that time.
Carter Blackburn, Stephen Bardo from Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas. Final home game for the fourth-ranked Jayhawks. Tolbert again. With he blocks it this time. Johnson turns it over.
Until Ty Nurse is not comfortable handling the basketball in traffic like that.
So back it out and run the half-court offense, the game plan for Texas Tech. Pick and roll for Crockett. Tolbert over Withy this time. Good battle inside.
Yeah, Withy's got to be careful. He's got one foul already. Texas Tech is doing a good job of getting the ball along the baseline, whether via the penetration off the bounce or penetration and then kick to an open teammate.
Relaford misses.
See, now Texas Tech kind of has the game and it's the way they like it in terms of their pace. Taking their time, running their half-court offense, not allowing Kansas to get out on the break and get easy looks.
Relaford says hello, one of the men in stripes. Jordan Tolbert, unafraid on the post, trying to lead Texas Tech.
Well, you mentioned the Fort Worth native going right at the best shot blocker in the country and having his way here early.
Anish Roff in studio, Louisville taking on Cincinnati. The Cardinals clinch a double bye in the Big East tournament with a win. There's Peyton Siva to Shane Bohannon for the easy two, and then Siva, the preseason Big East player of the year, all by himself. Louisville up by 7 midway through the first half. Carter?
Well, Anish, that Louisville team coming off a big win over Syracuse. Some other NCAA news and notes. Gonzaga is now number one.
Yeah, it's a great honor for Mark Few and the way that he's built that program up over the years, the consistency that they've had. And to me, this might be their deepest ball club. And Michigan State was an absolute war. That was a non-pretty Big Ten game. And then Villanova just struggling to try to stay in among the 68.
Michigan closes out on Sunday against Indiana, the now number two team in the country. Although Joe Lunardi projects Indiana as a number one seed, Kansas also projected a number one seed.
Yeah, Indiana, that Big Ten, you could just close your eyes and point to six teams and like, okay, we're going over there. Okay, we got a chance to get beat. I don't care if you're Indiana, I don't care if you're Michigan. That has been a gauntlet this season, Big Ten Conference.
Ohio State, Indiana tomorrow, and then again Indiana versus Michigan on Sunday.
Ohio State lurking around, one of those teams that can really do some damage come tournament time.
After a 7-0 start here for Kansas, Texas Tech has fought back. 8 to shoot for the Red Raiders.
I'm not sure Gray's aware of it.
4 to shoot. The freshman point guard pops into the rim. Crockett dunks it down. Maybe he was aware.
I think he was aware. Drew all the defense away from Crockett on the backside. Excellent execution by the Red Raiders.
Jamari Traylor turns it over.
Well, Texas Tech. Gray setting the play up. Coming hard. That hard dribble drew three defenders right there. Allowing Tolbert on the backside. Excuse me, Crockett rather, on the backside for the alley-oop. Josh Gray setting the table here early for Texas Tech. You know, Carter, this is similar to the way the Red Raiders played at Kansas State last week. They were in that game 14 minutes in the second half.
That's a foul called on Tharp, and that is his second.
His second personal foul, third team foul. Elijah Johnson.
Not often when you can quiet the fog crowd, but Texas Tech really has everyone back on their seats right now. Kind of wondering, like, what's going on? This is Texas Tech. Only 3 wins in the Big 12 Conference.
They missed an inbound lob to Tolbert, too. Crockett. Texas Tech had lost 9 straight before a Saturday home win over TCU.
Patience of Kansas once again, swinging the ball from side to side.
Lob to Young.
Kevin Young is enjoying it. snuck along the backside or on the baseline. That's why you have to have pressure on the passer at all times. That's why coaches scream, get your hands up like Travis Relford did that time.
Senior to senior for the first Kansas bucket in nearly 6 minutes.
Well, this is the good ball movement. That's why you want to swing the ball from side to side. Jay Crockett a little late reacting to Kevin Young going to the rim.
Think he's enjoying his senior night?
Yes, he is. He's been able to watch him over his career. And he gets it. You know, he understands it's a privilege to play, not a right. He comes out and plays that way.
Gray will reset. In the paint, past Johnson, tipped away by Young. This time it's McLemore. Young gets the follow.
Kevin Young does all the glue stuff. Everything that the dirty work, running the floor, tip ins, setting screens, and he's being rewarded for his effort as his mom and his brother enjoying it. Josh Gray getting to the bucket, trying for the feed. Kevin Young comes up with a deflection, tracks the ball down. Beautiful lead pass, and then cleans the basket up. Kevin Young did everything.
Young has the last four for Kansas. Jayhawks lead it by 7 tomorrow night on ESPNU. Both these games, big March implications, Virginia Tech versus Duke, and then Alabama and Ole Miss. Marshall Henderson and Ole Miss have played themselves off the bubble, trying to get back on.
Marshall Henderson was 3 of 18 in their loss to Mississippi State. You talk about a team decimated this season by injuries. Mississippi State had a grad assistant go down with a torn ACL. So tough, tough loss for Ole Miss as they are the second, believe they're the last team in the second four out in Lenardi's last bracketology.
So Monday, Tuesday on the U, it's a Relaford doubleheader. Travis in Kansas on Monday, Trevor and the Tide on Tuesday against Ole Miss.
And believe me, Trevor's watching right now, watching his big bro in his last home game in the fog, and the roles will be reversed tomorrow. Crimson Tide needing some big wins down the stretch as well to secure their spot in the big dance.
Relaford's from Kansas City. 10 to shoot. Into Tolbert. Draws three defenders. Young strips it. Relaford, power dribble to the rim. And Tech gives it right back.
Relaford with the side two-step here on the move. Catches it, sidesteps Hannah's for the easy bucket. Kansas starting to get their offense on track by getting some easy ones in the fast break.
Six straight for Kansas after Texas Tech had it to 3.
What you see with a young team like Texas Tech, obviously they don't have the talent level of Kansas, so their margin of error is so razor thin.
Especially when it's Johnson to Whitney for the alley-oop dunk.
Elijah Johnson going in, looking like a hook shot. It was an alley-oop all the way.
Kansas on the run again. McLemore blocked.
What an athletic play right there by Crockett.
Williams turns it over. Young to Withy. Foul on Crockett.
Well, I know this is the home of Wilt to Stilt, but Elijah Johnson doing his best. Kareem with the hook pass to Jeff Whitney coming home on senior night. And you see the look. Yes, sir, big fella. I like that.
It's a winning spurt. It is senior night here at Allen Fieldhouse, but it is also the likely last home game for the redshirt freshman, Ben McLemore.
Yeah, anywhere from top five to the number one pick projected in this year's NBA draft. Ben McLemore has had games like last game against West Virginia where he is definitely one of the best in the country.
A Wendy's Wooden Watch, two midseason top 25 candidates for the Jayhawks, Ben McLemore and the senior Jeff Whitney.
Yeah, quite an honor for both of those guys to be in the group of elite players, and their production justifies them being there.
And here is why it's likely the last home game for Ben McLemore. Top three prospects headed by McLemore. Nerlens Noel, of course, had the season-ending knee injury, and Marcus Smart at Oklahoma State.
Yeah, that's quite a trio right there. We'll have to see how Nerlens Noel comes off of his knee injury and how strong he'll be. But Ben McLemore and Marcus Smart, tremendous upside at the next level.
And, Stephen, a lot of people talk about the one-and-done rule. If you read the USA Today piece that was out last week or any of the features that have been written about Ben McLemore's growing up, you say what a blessing it is for that young man to have an opportunity to make a lot of money at the next level whenever he has that ability to take care of his family who has grown up in difficult circumstances.
You're exactly right. And we get a little selfish in college basketball because we want to see these guys stay longer. We want to get to know them a little bit better. We want to see them get better and better. But when you have an opportunity to go help your family, because he comes from a very poor background in St. Louis, you got to, you know, encourage the young man to do what he needs to do that's best for his family.
Jordan Tolbert gets that lay-in for Tech to make it 11. Relaford bumped. And the way that Bill Self talks about Ben McLemore, really off the court and the way he has enjoyed the university experience, it reminds me of what the Texas folks said about Kevin Durant. Yes, this guy's talented. Yes, he'll be an NBA player after his freshman year, 1 year in college, but he has really embraced what it took to get him. I mean, he was a partial academic qualifier, couldn't even practice with his team when he got here to campus, put his nose in the books, got academically eligible, one of the best college players in the country, and a likely number one pick in the NBA draft.
And he's taken to the experience and understands that this is special being at Kansas. I mean, he had his choice of where he could have gone to school, but understanding that he's a Midwest kid, grew up in St. Louis in the shadow of the Big 12 Conference, recognizing the dominance of the Jayhawks, and he wanted to be a part of it. And that's the key. He wasn't going to be the man. He was going to be a part of the tradition here, and he's fit right in.
Still room for growth in the game, though, for as talented as Ben McLemore is.
Oh, it's a tremendous amount, because Oklahoma State, the game that we did at Kansas at Oklahoma State, the double overtime thriller, he was rendered a non-factor by the defense of Oklahoma State.
Relaford blocked at the rim and fouled. But Elijah Johnson has a huge smile. The seniors are really enjoying it.
Oh, man, trying to go behind the back, away from the D, and then dunking at the rim. Travis Relaford trying to get every bit of his experience in Fog Allen out tonight.
That's a first on Tapsoba. Already 18 fouls against Texas Tech, so Kansas is in the bonus. Shooting foul here for Relaford. This game was 13-10. Texas Tech was hanging with Kansas after an early run, and since then, all Jayhawks, a 13-2 run.
Yeah, they've been able to get out on the break. They're attacking the rim. They're not settling for jump shots, and they're getting stops as well.
Make it a 15-2 run.
Texas Tech right here, I'd go back to Tolbert. He was having pretty good success against Whitney early. I would get him at the bucket once again. Try to stop this Kansas run.
Williams draws a foul going to the floor. It's on Whitney. That is the first personal foul on Whitney. They earlier changed a foul to Nadir Tharp. That's the first on Whitney.
Okay, because I remember them calling the first foul, so Kansas getting a pretty good break.
Safe to say Bill Self did not agree with the call.
No, Bill Self saying that he was passing the basketball as opposed to shooting. And I think Self is right. I think they make her. Yep.
And they've changed it.
Yeah, they changed it. Nice job of the officials coming together and getting the call right. That's the most important thing.
Paul Jansen, Jerry Pollard, and Kip Kissinger are officials tonight. Now the other head coach is not happy. Chris Walker, who is a terrific player at Villanova, for Rolly Massimino. Crockett traveled.
Boy, you can see that coming. On the inbounds, Kansas turned up the heat defensively, denying the first and second options. Just tough for Texas Tech to get anything going.
Johnson attacks. Off the McLemore bobble now, back to Johnson. Lob for Young. The senior slam.
In this run to get this lead, Carter, Kevin Young's fingerprints are all over this run right now.
A 16-2 Kansas run. Six assists from Elijah Johnson. Withy for three. The first three-pointer of the season for Jeff Withy.
Kevin Young setting the pick. Does it so well that Crockett has to help. He's able to go unabated to the rim. And Jeff Withy, senior day.
The first career three-pointer for Jeff Withy. He is now a perfect 100% in his Kansas career from 3 points. 1 for 1.
And I love it. I mean, these guys are, they put the work in. They've been here, seniors. Why not Jeff Withy get a chance to shoot a three? He does all the dirty work in the paint anyway. Got to reward a big fella.
A 19-2 run for Kansas, led by the seniors. Been Withy with the alley-oop, and now with his first career three-pointer. He didn't touch the rim, Stephen.
No, so you know that he's been able to do that for quite a while. Bill Self holding the reins down a little bit.
Withy already with 12, Young with 10. And Elijah Johnson has 7 assists. In fact, all 7 assists in the game for Kansas from Elijah Johnson. He is enjoying setting up his senior teammates. Push shot goes for Dusty Hannes to stymie the run at 19-2.
That's what Kansas does to you. You're in the game, you're in the game, you make a turnover, they get a run out and a steal, or they get a dunk right here.
McLemore into the end.
That's a set play to run McLemore from one baseline around the elbow for a backside lob.
Watch out. Blocking foul, count the bucket.
Here's a play, watch, where McLemore starts around Withy, then comes around Kevin Young, and if you go over the top, you have no help baseline side, set play for Kansas. We saw that a couple times in the last game versus West Virginia.
So the starting five, the 4 seniors and Ben McLemore, all of them playing their last game at Allen Fieldhouse. That is certainly most likely for Ben McLemore, the number one prospect and likely number one pick in the NBA draft, one way or another. These five playing their last home game in Lawrence.
And you mentioned McLemore being number one pick. They've got the next number one pick in the house visiting right now.
Andrew Wiggins, and we will tell you more about Mr. Wiggins very shortly. Already the Kansas crowd is chanting, "We want Wiggins," at various points. Withy. Second chance. Bowling his way to the basket.
I won't be surprised if Chris Walker gets a technical behind that. That was a swallow your whistle type deal there.
Withy's been a part of a couple famous no calls.
Yes, he has.
This one may be less famous. Either way, the Jayhawks are having fun on senior night. Smiles all around for KU. Not so much for Texas Tech.
And Ish Schroff in studio coming up at halftime. A little bracketology. Will examine the one seeds. Kansas now on the top line. Plus, how Gonzaga made history today. And we'll have an update on Cincinnati and Louisville. Carter.
Indeed, Anish, Kansas less than a month after a three-game losing streak, including the loss at TCU. The Jayhawks are back to the number four ranking in the nation and a projected number one seed. And speaking of number one, the number one prospect in next year's high school class, Andrew Wiggins, is in the building.
Yeah, Andrew Wiggins is a special talent. His mom right next to him was an Olympic track athlete out of Canada. His father, Mitchell Wiggins, I had some personal experience with him when he spent some time in Champaign while Kendall Gill, Nick Anderson, Kenny Battle, and I were there, and he wore us out every time we played. So Andrew Wiggins, when I knew that was his father, I knew that young man has tremendous upside, the athleticism and from his mother, but the know-how, smarts, and toughness from his father. He's going to be an outstanding prospect.
Mother Marita was an Olympic track athlete as well. So now both Father Mitchell and Mother Marita went to Florida State. So in there in the recruiting battle, Florida State as well. But the visit to Kansas today, Andrew Wiggins, 2 years from now, projected. I mean, this is clearly, folks are saying, the number one NBA prospect 2 years from now.
If he was allowed to come out, he'd probably be the number one prospect right now. 48-inch vertical. That's 6'7".
Which means with Ben McLemore on the floor right now and Andrew Wiggins behind the Kansas bench at Allen Fieldhouse tonight, you have the likely number one picks in the next two NBA drafts.
Yes, you do. And Andrew Wiggins saw him down at the Peach Jam, a large AAU event in the summer. And he took another young man out of Texas, Julius Randle, that visited here and is top five in the country and ate him up. Just D'd him up. Julius Randle wanted no parts of Andrew Wiggins after that game.
Randle was here last week. McLemore, a couple of misses on this trip down for KU.
Texas Tech trying to go to a little zone just to keep the Jayhawks out of the paint.
Foul called on Withy. That is his second. ESPN's Journey to the Tourney, the season-long spotlight on games that will impact the tournament. A big one tomorrow night, Ohio State versus Indiana, 9 o'clock Eastern. Tough week for Ohio State. They have Indiana and then at Michigan on Sunday.
Indiana, I know Gonzaga's ranked number one, but I still think the best team in the nation, the Hoosiers. I just think they're battle-tested through the Big Ten. They've got Victor Oladipo, who to me is up for player of the year. Zeller, Yogi Ferrell at the point guard position, freshman, has been very solid. And don't forget this, Will Sheehy is a pro. The sixth man for Indiana. Will Sheehy and Victor Oladipo, I think, can have 10-year careers at the next level.
We talked about this on Saturday, Steve, when we had the A-10 battle between Butler and VCU. It wasn't much of a battle. But St. Louis, potential Final Four team.
No doubt about it. They get Quamaine Mitchell back with Jordair Jett, McCall, at the guard positions. They've got depth, they've got size, they're physical, they're a veteran ball club. They forced 23 turnovers against Butler. They've beaten Butler twice, once at their place and once in Hinkle Fieldhouse. So St. Louis, another team to watch out for.
That's an air ball from Jay Crockett, Texas Tech's leading scorer and rebounder.
This is Chris Walker. In these situations with his team, he's not really concerned about the score. He's trying to get good possessions, staying within the team concept. That's why he's pulling Crockett out of the game right now. Not necessarily to berate him, but that's a teaching moment.
And now a 2-3 zone from Tech. Kansas dunks right over.
Once again, it's very difficult if you don't have ball pressure on the passer. Kansas will pick you apart.
8 assists now for Elijah Johnson. Johnson pushes Kansas again. Off the hands of McLemore.
Carter last time down along the baseline. Watch the screen by Perry Ellis right there. Look at Trailer. And then that's just too easy. No communication on the back line. Two screens for the baseline bigs of Texas Tech, allowing Ben McLemore a free run at the rim. The last time Texas Tech came into Fog Allen during senior night, they left with a 50-point defeat.
Foreshadowing.
Yes. Kind of looks similar right now.
This game was 13-10, so 30-8 since.
So this Jayhawk ball club can do to you. Again, this is not a young team. We talked about the four seniors that started the game. Integral part. This is the difference between a lot of the teams around the country. Not many teams that have four seniors starting that Bill Self can rely on.
Bill Self will take a timeout.
Head coach Charlie Weiss and the Kansas football team are gearing up for the annual spring football game on Saturday, April 15th.
At Baylor on Saturday to close it out, do you think the Bears will be excited about having Kansas coming into their building with the potential NCAA at-large bid on the line?
Not only excited, but being in the first four out right now, needing a quality win to offset those non-conference losses early in the year at home to College of Charleston and also to Northwestern. So Baylor, in a really tough way, lost their last game to Kansas State, had an inbounds, tried to throw a long pass to Isaiah Alston. It goes out of bounds. Kansas State gets it underneath Baylor's basket. Rodney Magruder pops free at the top of the key. It's a three. Buzzer is the game. A heartbreaking loss for Baylor.
Kansas State, Oklahoma State on Saturday. So the Big 12 regular season championship likely be determined on Saturday. Seven to shoot here. Blocking foul called on Jordan Tolbert.
It looked like Chris Walker was trying to talk to Dusty Hannes. I think he was not in the proper position. Help side defensively, allowing Relaford to turn the corner. Travis Relaford enjoying his last game here at Fog.
There's a lot to enjoy right now for Kansas and the seniors.
Yeah, these guys are, you want your team playing the best in March. This Kansas team is playing their best basketball, sharing the rock as well as any team in the nation right now.
memories of Kansas' three-game losing streak from less than a month ago are waning. Tolbert gets the tip in, but it is all KU in the first 20. A 25-point lead on Texas Tech at the half. A senior night celebration at Allen Fieldhouse. Closing the half on a 32-10 run. For a full update from the studio, we send it now to Anish Shroff and Dino Gaudio, the SportsCenter U halftime report. Yes, indeed, on Big Monday presented by Bud Light, it is a big lead for the Kansas Jayhawks, all KU on senior night. Welcome back to Allen Fieldhouse. Carter Blackburn with Stephen Bardo. And rather than show you the first half highlights or the first half stats, I think the biggest question is which of these highlights is going to be a SportsCenter top 10, and maybe which one is going to be number one.
Yeah, there's plenty to choose from as we take a look here. To me, Carter, this is the best one right there. Behind the back, and he was feeling it, feeling good about himself. That was pretty sweet too, but the assist is better than the dunk, I think, with the hook pass.
Oh, now that's a point guard talking right there, Mr. Bardo.
But the hook, he threw a hook pass to a big fella rolling to the hole.
So you've got the four seniors playing in their last home game. They've all had tremendous first half, and then Ben McLemore, who is all but certain to be playing in his last home game as a Kansas Jayhawk, likely the number one pick in next year's NBA draft, certainly a top five pick. So the five that take the floor for the second half of Kansas playing their final minutes as Kansas Jayhawks and certainly making the most of them.
Yeah, they're having fun doing it as well. And not at the expense of Texas Tech, but just having fun and understanding you get a lot of emotion in the second half of these games, Carter. It was a long time ago when I experienced it, but I remember it like it was yesterday.
This game was 13-10, so Texas Tech withstood an early 7-0 run by Kansas, was hanging top with the Jayhawks, and then the dominant 32-10 run, and Jeff Whitney gets the second half started for Kansas.
Just reestablishing themselves and their superiority in the paint area. Kansas worked their way out from there.
A Kansas team who has won six straight following the three-game losing streak, the first for Kansas basketball in 8 years. Kravitz turns it over. And unfortunately for Texas Tech, this looks like the game that you mentioned earlier, Stephen, when the last time the Texas Tech was here for a Kansas senior night.
It's just tough anytime you go and play somebody at their place senior night. You better have a really good ball club because you're going to be up against a lot of emotion in the building. And they pick up on their fans here. This is arguably the best home court in the nation, Fog Allen. It's a special emphasis wanting to send their seniors out on the right note.
Got to see Dave Armstrong at the half, and he will have Texas Tech, or rather have TCU against Kansas State tomorrow night for the Wildcats senior night. Whitney has the first four of the second half for Kansas. 16 in the game now for Whitney.
Seems as though Kansas is going to some more set plays here to get some of their seniors off. We may see some of them come out of the game here not so long if it continues this way.
McLemore runs the break. Elijah Johnson had 9 assists in the first half. McLemore fouled by Jordan Tolbert, third on the sophomore big man for the Red Raiders.
Ball movement is just so good with these Jayhawks. There's no agendas, no clicks. You can tell these guys, if their teammate is open, they get them the basketball.
And how about Elijah Johnson for Kansas? I mean, a guy who really had to fight through a lot of criticism, coached tough by Bill Self and the Kansas coaching staff, but Elijah said, I knew where I belonged. I belonged here at Kansas, never thought about going anywhere else, and he's reaping the rewards right now as of the Jayhawks.
He is, and you mentioned he got called out a little bit, and he's not a true point guard. But what happens is you either wilt or you respond, and Elijah Johnson responded in a big way, but also the play of Nadir Tharp. has helped because Nadir comes in and takes some of the pressure off on the point guard position and allows Elijah to move over to the two from time to time.
Elijah Johnson, the easy pick for Big 12 Player of the Week after he had a spectacular 39 at Iowa State, including 20 in the 6 minutes at the end of regulation and in overtime.
He was fantastic, and Kansas needed every single point, but a lot of people talked in that game about the officiating and what happened. But Iowa State was up 7 with a minute 45 left. They handled their business. They touched on the win.
Kansas blowing out Texas Tech on senior night. Today, here's what the Phillips 66 Big 12 Championship would look like, beginning with a coverage on ESPN3, all on the ESPN network. So look over there to the left in the 8-9 game, Texas versus Texas Tech, meaning that the Jayhawks, after their first round bye, would face either the Longhorns or the Red Raiders.
And the Longhorns, I'm not so sure you want to face them right now the way Mike Obongo is playing. Texas playing really for pride with him being back. Probably feeling this is his last chance to showcase his skills at this level because he's probably gonna put his name in the draft.
How about the comeback last week against Oklahoma by Kabongo in Texas?
Yeah, and I did that game down 22 with 8 minutes left, and they make a furious comeback and then win it in overtime. So, yeah, that was a tough defeat for Oklahoma, but Texas has that ability.
This would be a bigger comeback.
Yeah, but Texas Tech doesn't have a Mike Kabongo. They don't have anybody that can take over the game quite like that. But if you're Chris Walker again, just have you guys try not to look at the score so much, but stay within themselves and don't do anything outside of their game plan.
That's a nice look. Finished off by Jay Crockett.
You also have to talk to your team about a sense of pride. And just don't want Kansas just to run roughshod over you, although 31 points, just, you know, it's tough to deal with.
Johnson misses the dunk off the lob from Withy. Reverse of the way it usually goes between Johnson and Withy. Johnson will walk it up now for the Jayhawks. He is one assist away from tying his career high, which he had on Saturday against West Virginia. Travis Relaford finds Withy, fouled, sending us to an official timeout. Kansas continues to roll on senior day.
On May 6th, 1985, identical twins were separated at birth. Despite their different upbringings, they were both born to assist. Chris Paul was destined for a life of basketball. Cliff Paul was destined for a life of helping others, and that led him to become a State Farm agent. When assisting is in your blood, you know it. Find an agent born to get you to a better state.
Tomorrow night on ESPNU, ACC-SEC doubleheader with the nation's leading scorer, Eric Green, and Virginia Tech against third-ranked Duke at 7 Eastern, and then Alabama-Ole Miss. Critical game for March. Chances for the Tide and for Ole Miss at 9 Eastern. That's Super Tuesday.
Yeah, you talk about Duke, and this Ryan Kelly's performance against Miami is an indication that they took it very slowly with him. To come back against Miami and have 36 and be that efficient, his conditioning was there. His timing was there. His feel for the game was there. Anytime you miss 13 games in season, you come back and have a performance like that, that tells me that Mike Krzyzewski was overly cautious, knowing how important Ryan Kelly is to them down the stretch. He was willing to sacrifice some wins and some losses there to make sure that they were ready for the stretch run. Ryan Kelly, that might have been the best performance I've ever seen coming off an injury like that in a game of that magnitude.
Think about the performances on Saturday. Kelly in the bounce back with 36. Doug McDermott had 41 in his senior day for Creighton. And then Ben McLemore, looking at the Jayhawks, had 36 on Saturday against West Virginia, the Kansas freshman scoring record.
And you're talking about McDermott doing that against Wichita State, which is a sound defensive ball club with the Missouri Valley crown on the line, and didn't miss a shot from two-point range.
Tapped out. It will be Texas Tech basketball. This Red Raider team is 3-13. They're getting blown out tonight after a Saturday win over TCU, but that's just the beginning of the story for Chris Walker and the last few years of Texas Tech basketball. Took over as interim head coach following Billy Gillespie's resignation in September. And you go back just a number of years, Bob Knight, Pat Knight, Billy Gillespie, and now Chris Walker. I mean, a guy like Jay Crockett, recruited by Bob, played for Pat. And now Chris Walker is the interim head coach. And I know a lot of folks around Lubbock and around this Red Raider program are pulling for Chris Walker to have that interim tag removed.
Well, I think Chris Walker has the right approach in terms of this season because of all the turmoil that took place replacing Billy Gillespie, and understanding that you just got to have the right mentality and the right attitude. And I think his players have done that. We talked about it early on, seeing them in shoot around. You wouldn't know that this team had a 9-game losing streak during the year. They were upbeat. They go hard. They pull for one another. Chris Walker says they're great young men. And so I think he understood what was most important in restoring the program, or trying to put his stamp on the program, is delve into the kids and get them to believe in themselves and be positive.
Jamari Trainor, second in the Jayhawk lineup, replacing Jeff Whitney.
Chris Walker also points out one of five academic all Big 12 members on this Texas Tech team. So they have performed well in the classroom. Factor this in for Texas Tech. Six players left following last season, 15 during Billy Gillespie's year and a half as head coach of Texas Tech basketball. Remarkable attrition.
Yeah, it is a remarkable attrition. It's remarkable that they have three wins in Big 12 play, because when you have that type of turnover, you have no consistency whatsoever. And if you're looking out on the court right now, you've got talented players in Jordan Tolbert, Josh Gray, and Jay Crockett. But besides that, just too much turnover for this program to expect to be consistently competing at this level of conference.
One of two at the free throw line for Tolbert, the sophomore. Texas Tech will have him back next year. And potentially Keith Frazier, who is a highly regarded prospect out of Dallas Kimball, who's considering Texas Tech. When we talk about the Red Raiders and Texas Tech basketball, you have to talk about Gerald Myers, who has taken on very much a teaching role with the interim head coach Chris Walker. There's Gerald Myers, a former Texas Tech head coach and athletic director, and Chris says he has been such a big help, taking notes, giving him assistance in his first year coaching Texas Tech or any college program.
Well, Chris Walker uses a phrase from Gerald and he got from him and said that you can't rush experience. So you got freshmen, they're going to take their lumps. You can't make them juniors overnight. And understanding that this situation requires a tremendous amount of patience and focus on just trying to get these guys to be ready to play each and every night.
Chris Walker is a native Texan. Mentioned earlier that he played at Villanova. Says he's relied heavily on Jay Wright and Steve Lapis. It's a good half-court offense from the Red Raiders. Kravitz can't finish it off. KU ball.
Dalen Robinson doing a good job getting in the paint. That was a nice shovel pass. Kravitz got to finish that. As a guard, you give the rock up in that situation where he could have taken a shot. Next time he gets in that position, he may think twice about that shovel pass.
Daylon Robinson is from Kansas City, played at Northeast High School. Hasn't scored yet in the game for the Red Raiders. This is Elijah Johnson. The senior night celebration continues.
Make it look easy. You mentioned it earlier, Carter. So look at this team now. When they had that three-game slide, it was just really something to behold.
This team would not lose to Topeka YMCA.
No, Jamari Traylor, excellent hustle defensively on the back tap. Elijah Johnson laughing at Nadir Tharp's attempt at an alley-oop. I don't know if Will Chamberlain would have caught that one.
The lead is 38. Texas Tech has scored only 3 second-half points. Make it 5.
And Andrew White hurt himself there trying to come out and got his ankle tangled up defensively. If you look at the future of this Jayhawk program, there's going to be some opportunity for playing time next season with these four seniors leaving. Look at some of the underclassmen right now. Got Rio Adams right there. Andrew White, who is an excellent shooter, has been used in the stretch four position at times. There's Justin Wesley on the bench, Rio Adams on the left. Nico Roberts, the son of Norm Roberts, assistant coach at Kansas, on the right. But there's going to be some opportunity next year for the freshman coming in, and also for a player like Andrew Wiggins, if he so chooses to come.
One way or another, Kansas is going to have a talented freshman class next year. Whether that includes that young man or not, Andrew Wiggins, the number one recruit in the nation, who's on his official visit to Kansas.
You know, it's funny. I watch these guys, and they make their visits to campus now. The parents are there. You know, my parents didn't come to any of my visits, and I'm glad about it.
And I presume that's all you're going to say, Mr. Bardo.
Oh, I could be PC about it, but hey, you know, you're on college campus and you gotta figure out the social aspect of where you're gonna be for 1 to 4 years for a guy like him, maybe one, but for a guy like me, I was gonna be there for 4 years, so I wanted to get a feel of the place.
Literally. Hannes knocks down the three for Texas Tech.
Hey, my father, who's an ex-student athlete at Southern Illinois University, played basketball in the late 50s, early 60s. He's an administrator now at Southern Illinois University. And, you know, he told me, he said, the most important thing about college is the social experience. And his thing was, the friends you make in college will be the friends you have for the rest of your life.
And?
He was exactly right. But I took the social part a little further than I think he wanted me to. So I thoroughly enjoyed my 4 years of college.
What kind of guidance did your high school coach give you in your decision about college, Stephen?
I had a very special high school coach who is now the athletic director at South Florida, University of South Florida, Doug Woolard. And he ran a college program in high school. And he gave us all the information, laid it out, and said, now you make the decision. But Doug Woolard, I still talk to him today and love him dearly, and he was tremendous in the whole recruiting process.
Son Chris is a terrific administrator with the University of Kentucky basketball program. Innovative.
Yes, he is. And John Calipari, you know, talking to Chris, got him out of Conference USA where he was an administrator, now part of the Big Blue Nation.
That foul on Rio Adams will send us to an official timeout. Kansas by 33. We'll talk about the Jayhawks prospects in the NCAA tournament when we come back. The favorite airport app of all ESPN college basketball announcers, the Watch ESPN app. You can watch anytime, anywhere on your mobile device or at watchespn.com. We use it like a super DVR. You watch, go back and watch any game on the ESPN networks.
Yeah, and for all you guys out there that get that app, be careful. It's addictive.
Yes. Yes, indeed. Pay heed. Joe Lenardi's Bracketology, ESPN.com, the inside RPI. Kansas is projected as a number one seed. Kansas State right now projected as a three.
Yeah, and that's a solid footing for this Big 12 conference. And Baylor having to really work, as well as Iowa State, to maintain their dancing shoes. They've got some work to do here down the stretch. Going to be a lot of turnover among those teams on the bottom there.
Bill Self of the Jayhawks trying to get a ninth straight Big 12 conference title. Go down to Saturday.
I mean, it's an amazing run when you really look at it. Some of the players on both of these ball clubs, they've never seen another team. When basketball became important to them, they've never seen another team win the Big 12 besides Kansas. You know, and so if you're in this part of the country especially, and you're fortunate enough to get recruited by Kansas, you're coming in understanding what tradition and history and dominance the Jayhawks have enjoyed in this Big 12 conference.
And they packed Allen Fieldhouse again tonight. Always fun for us to come here and be courtside at Allen Fieldhouse.
Oh, well, we understand the history of it. We're removed from it and a little bit older, and we go to different venues, and there's none better in college basketball than Fog Allen.
And the senior night celebration, which occurs after the game at Allen Fieldhouse. The seniors were recognized beforehand, but they will have a chance to address the crowd here at Allen Fieldhouse. That senior night ceremony is live following the game on ESPN3. A 33-point edge for Kansas in what was early on a 13-10 basketball game. Jayhawks then went on a 30-8 run to take command against Texas Tech and the last home game of the year for Kansas basketball. That's an offensive foul called on Jamari Traylor, a redshirt freshman.
Jamari Traylor is going to be a good one. And he got a lot of playing time early in the season, especially against Michigan State, when the Spartans were able to beat Kansas in Atlanta. But he's done what a lot of freshmen typically do. They're up and down, they're not consistent, and he's got to understand that it's not so much on the offensive end, it's the defensive end and the little things that will get you more playing time for a guy like Bill Self.
Speaking of, Kansas has held opponents at 35% shooting this year. No Bill Self Kansas team has allowed opponents to shoot 40% for a season. That's amazing.
Yes, it is. And it's a tribute to their dedication to that end of the floor. It's also a tribute, I think, to Jeff Whitney and his ability to clean up mistakes on the back line. You have a shot blocker like that, you can take a few more chances on the perimeter and maybe get a little bit closer, kneecap to kneecap, D'ing people up. You've got an eraser on the back line.
Speaking about the defense for Kansas, Barry Henson, well, you know what, I'm going to save that until a possession where they make a stop. Oh, why not? Barry Henson, who's now the head coach in Southern Illinois, who was the director of basketball operations last year, a position that's now held by Doc Sadler. Bill Self and Barry Henson were together as undergraduates at Oklahoma State when Henry Iba was still alive, and they got to pick Henry Iba's Hall of Fame basketball mind about the game. And Barry Henson told me, Mr. Iba said, all you young guys are concerned about how you can put it in the hoop. Basketball begins with how you keep it out of the hoop.
I like that.
And that was the foundation for Mr. Iba and the way that he taught the basketball game to so many terrific coaches, including Barry Henson and Bill Self and Doc Sadler and many, many others.
Well, it shows in their approach and their philosophy and how they have their players and teams play. It's like Josh Gray and Rio Adams exchanging pleasantries there.
By the way, I mentioned Barry Henson was last year the director of basketball operations, last couple of years with Kansas basketball, now with Southern Illinois. I think Doc Sadler will be back in a head coaching position at some point very soon.
No doubt about it. The job he did at Nebraska was, he didn't get a lot of credit for it, but very competitive. And it never really had a tremendous amount of size or depth, but was always competitive. And he made the transition for Nebraska moving from the Big 12 into the Big 10.
Now the seniors check back into the game for Kansas. So big round of applause for the starting five who are playing their last game at Allen Fieldhouse. The four seniors and the redshirt freshman, Ben McLemore, who is expected to go very early in the NBA draft. So this five on the floor for Kansas right now, playing their final minutes at Allen Fieldhouse. Elijah Johnson.
One of the toughest things to do out of a zone defense is rebound the basketball. Texas Tech is finding that to be the case right now.
McLemore. Nobody can make a three except for Jeff Withey. The only made three of the night for Kansas is from Jeff Withey, his first career. He's more used to that position.
They are moving the basketball inside out. Tech just can't keep up. Can't put any pressure on the basketball. Kansas fans happy to see these five on the floor for the last time here in Frog Allen.
McLemore steals it. Relaford gives it right back.
And McLemore with the assist from Travis Relaford.
Then McLemore looks like he's jogging, but he's beating everyone else when he's jogging. He's just a natural.
Withey fights for the rebound. Johnson runs the Jayhawks again. Withey. Jams it home. Elijah Johnson gets the assist. He now has 11 in the game. That is his career high on senior night.
He seemed determined to set all of his teammates up before looking for his own. Well, you talk about St. Louis. The city's got a lot of great players that have come out of there. But Ben McLemore might be the finest to ever come out of the city. That's home of the Arch. Ben McLemore getting it done.
ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. That's how much fun senior night is right now for the Kansas Jayhawks. Bill Self in the middle of the huddle is telling the guys to just look up and watch the pop-up trivia on the Kansas seniors. Enjoy it, guys. Hey, you have to work really hard to get to that point.
Yes, you do. And that's tradition. That's guys buying in. And the rest is history.
Well, speaking of the opportunity for another Big 12 title, meaning the senior class would go perfect, 4-for-4, and one instance, 5-for-5. There is still, however, a possibility for a three-way tie atop the Big 12.
Well, Kansas State still has to go to Oklahoma State. That's an extremely tough game. And Baylor's going to give it their all in hosting Kansas in their last game. So if somehow Kansas State and Kansas lose on the last day, and Oklahoma State can beat Iowa State and beat Kansas State, you got a three-way tie for first place in the Big 12.
Kansas no trouble with Texas Tech tonight. This game was 13-10. Kansas exploded on a 30-8 run to take command. And now the starting five with four seniors and the redshirt freshman Ben McLemore.
I wonder how long Bill will leave him in, considering he doesn't want to run up the score. And he's trying to keep that smile off of his face on the sideline right now. But I think he's taking it all in, kind of looking at these guys and probably remembering some of the practices where he called them everything but a child of God and made them run sprints, made them get up early. All those different things that coaches, the influence and the interaction that they have with their players over a 4 or even 5 year period. In the case of Travis Relaford, all that stuff comes back at times like this.
Now think about that. This four-player senior class. You have Travis Relaford, who redshirted a year because Bill Self, after the sophomore season, said, look at the guys ahead of you, including Xavier Henry and Tyshawn Taylor and Grady Morningstar, and said, you're not going to crack the rotation. Why not take a year off, have an extra year of eligibility? You're going to play your last 2 years. You're going to be a starter your last 2 years. Kevin Young, who transferred in from Loyola Marymount. Jeff Withey, who went to Arizona, then came to Kansas. And Elijah Johnson, who had to go through some very bumpy periods as a Kansas Jayhawk to reach this point.
Yeah, it's patience, and it's tough at this level because everybody's looking at one and done. I guarantee you, if you talk to both teams, 70% of all the guys on the team think they're going to the NBA. Think they're first-round starters right now, and that's just the way college basketball is. So to have the patience of guys who have had success coming into college to come to Kansas and understand that, okay, I can sit out a year, I can redshirt a year, and I can listen to Bill Self because he's got a national championship, he's got experience under his belt, I'm going to trust him. And look at the results right now.
Now, what are the chances, Stephen, and what does Kansas have to do to close it out with another championship in 2013?
They're going to have to be able to handle a bigger guard that can score. Travis Relaford is an outstanding defender, but a lot of times he has to swing between positions because he's so strong defensively. But other than him, Elijah Johnson, not great at keeping a quick guard in front of him. Nadir Thorpe either. So a bigger guard that can score the basketball may give Kansas trouble, but everything else, I think they have it covered.
Including recoveries off missed lobs. McLemore threw it off the backboard. Kevin Young went and got it anyway. Young has 14 points.
You know, if you got pride as a player, this is a tough one for Tech. I don't care how many games you've lost or you've only won 3 games in conference play. These guys don't like getting beaten this badly. There's no moral victories or anything based on it being at Kansas or senior night.
Relaford with a three. Of the four seniors, three are in double-digit scoring, and Elijah Johnson has a new career high with 11 assists. And Jeff Withey has another block and an outlet for Relaford. And a follow for Young. Foul before the putback from Young.
Beautiful lead pass, and Relaford right there with the miss, and Kevin Young trying to get nasty on the follow, but Relaford was fouled. But one caution here, you know, you're rolling, you're playing well, you don't want to get these guys hurt. In this situation again, Texas Tech, they got a little pride. They don't want to see guys running in, getting layups and dunks consistently. They're going to foul at some point. Chris Walker trying to impart some wisdom to his young point guard, Josh Gray. Very talented young man. struggles with his outside shot, but he is one of the better guards in the Big 12 at getting, breaking the defense down and getting in the paint.
And again for Texas Tech, because of the huge attrition of the roster, Josh Gray has to play a much bigger role as a freshman than he normally would on a Big 12 team in contention. This is the walk on Luke Adams in to run the point.
Andrew White checks in to the Jayhawk lineup.
Andrew White will check in for Ben McLemore. The Deer Tharp checks in for Elijah Johnson. So the four seniors and Ben McLemore all check out with their senior night final home game at Allen Fieldhouse well in hand.
I guarantee you, Carter, I was fortunate enough to play 10 years of professional basketball, some little bit in the NBA, but a lot overseas, and I've had some great memories playing professionally. This is the best it's going to get. Even if you play in the NBA, it's so much more of a business. Guys aren't pulling for one another all the time. Everyone's not happy for your success at the next level. This is as good as it gets, and those guys will never forget that moment walking off the floor with their teammates in the home crowd cheering them on. This is so special for players, and it's tough for them to see that right now because they don't have any experience moving forward, but I guarantee you, you ask them 10 years from now, they'll never forget this night.
Asked Elijah Johnson, what will you think when you walk off the floor for the final time as a Jayhawk in front of these folks? He said, I have no idea. Don't know until I get there.
That's right, and he's exactly right. These guys have been, they've maintained their composure quite well. I have a feeling, though, when they get the microphone after the game, that's going to change.
Big block by Jamari Traylor. They could learn from the seniors on the outlets. Well, with the seniors and Ben McLemore on the bench, it's the next generation of Jayhawks on the floor. We'll evaluate next year's Jayhawks. A sneak preview next.
And a Schroff in studio coming up next. Lamont Middleton and North Carolina A&T take on Savannah State. MEAC basketball at the top of the hour right here on ESPNU. An update on the women's side in the Big East. UConn and Notre Dame tied at 64. Watch Skylar Diggins playing some defense. Notre Dame forcing the jump ball. They're tied with 15 seconds. Over on the men's side, Louisville up by 16 on Cincy. If the Cardinals hold, they'll clinch a double bye in the Big East tournament.
Denise here in Lawrence, Kansas. Let's take a look at tonight's game track brought to you by Taco Bell. This game was 13-10, Kansas on Texas Tech. Since then, it has been all Jayhawks, including 56 from the seniors.
And this, most of it's been at the rim. Just attacking the rim, alley-oops, dribble penetration, kicking to your teammate. Kansas putting on a clinic and how to dominate in the paint.
For Texas Tech, after they snapped a 9-game losing streak Saturday with a victory over TCU, they would be 3-14 in Big 12 competition. Well, the seniors and Ben McLemore, the starting five for Kansas, are playing their last home game at Allen Fieldhouse. They're on the bench. So now, Stephen Bardot, an opportunity to see some of the Jayhawks who will be relied upon more next year.
Yeah, and it's a good job for them because they don't get a chance to come in the game a lot. They don't get a lot of playing time. And you want to reward guys when they have that opportunity.
This is the Kansas class of 2013, ranked third already. However, there are still a couple of big prizes out there, including Andrew Wiggins, who's in the house tonight, and Julius Randle, who visited last week. So that recruiting class could get an even bigger boost.
And it's something to see Kansas be able to reload in every position. Small forward, center, shooting guard, point guard, another point guard. Wiggins could be that 3-4 slash, or Julius Randle could be that 4-3 slash guy. So Kansas, the embarrassment of riches continues.
Andrew Wiggins with Father Mitchell and Mother Marita here making his official visit to Lawrence, Kansas. And there they are, both tremendous athletes at Florida State. Mitchell played in the NBA and overseas as well.
People don't remember Mitchell Wiggins with Houston. He and Lewis Lloyd were unbelievable scoring two guard and small forward for the Rockets. He had a hiccup during his career, but came back, was able to play overseas, and Mitchell Wiggins, he was a tough customer.
Well, Kansas coach Bill Self will talk about this game and previewing March tomorrow, 4 Eastern on Cats Corner on ESPNU, joining Andy Katz, part of the All-Star lineup on Cats Corner tomorrow. Kansas fans will want to tune in to hear what Bill Self has to say about this senior group and about the difference from a team that less than a month ago had lost 3 straight, including the road loss at TCU, one of the biggest upsets of the year in college basketball, and has now won 7 straight and is in line for a number one seed in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, it's been quite a turnaround. You know, they suffered the biggest upset of the season, losing at TCU, and now to find themselves in the position where they're more comfortable and where they've been in years past in terms of being a number one seed. It's been quite a transformation here in the last month and a half.
And with the seniors and McLemore on the bench, it is now time for the walk-ons here at Allen Fieldhouse, featuring some prominent names, including Nico Roberts, who's at the free throw line now, the son of Kansas assistant head coach, former St. John's head coach Norm Roberts.
And Norm Roberts was with Bill Self at Illinois. Started my broadcast career doing radio, covering these guys. And Nico Roberts was a little fella, ball boy, was around gym rat. It's good to see him out on the floor tonight. His mom, Pascal, in the stands. Younger brother, supposed to be a pretty good point guard here at Lawrence.
Evan Manning, Tyler Self, Justin Wesley on the floor as well. Christian Garrett also, redshirt sophomore from Los Angeles. Those are the 5 on the floor right now for Kansas. So Bill Self, Norm Roberts, and Danny Manning all watching their sons out there at Allen Fieldhouse in the last home game of the season.
I'm a father of 2 sons, and I wonder how it is to coach your son at this level. Yeah, you saw Bill right there when Tyler went up for that jumper. It looked like he was holding his breath. Got to be quite an adjustment, but also being quite proud to see your son out there on the floor.
And with the game in hand, Rock Chalk. That's Luke Adams, the walk-on with a strip. Fouled by Roberts.
That's the 10th team foul on Kansas.
Coming up next in the MEAC, it's Savannah State versus North Carolina A&T.
This is not a good sound for opposing teams in the Big 12, because all of them have heard it at least once. You've had any sort of playing career, and you come in this building, you've heard this song
1 minute remaining.
And Evan Manning, Tyler Self, and Nico Roberts, all best friends, being able to be on the Kansas team together. What an opportunity.
Roberts fouls Gocher, the season low for a Kansas opponent. It's 41. There's Danny Manning, now the Tulsa head coach.
Roderick Gocher, shooting two.
Evan, his son, right there. Thank goodness Evan looks like his mother. I had to get that in there for my buddy Danny. Well, Kansas setting themselves up nice and taking care of business at home. And going to have a tough one against Baylor, though. You know, Baylor is up and down ball club. They're going to be ready to play, and knowing that their NCAA tournament hopes may very well hinge on if they can beat Kansas in that last regular season game.
The Big 12 regular season title will come down to Saturday. Kansas takes care of business on senior night. A blowout win over Texas Tech here at Allen Fieldhouse, 79-42. The Jayhawks are 26-4, 14-3 in the Big 12. For Stephen Bardo, our entire crew from Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence, Kansas, I'm Carter Blackburn. 79-42, Kansas over Texas Tech. Now it's on to the MEAC.
Tonight, Lamont Middleton and the hometown North Carolina A&T Aggies host Preston Blackman and the Savannah State Tigers as the MEAC regular season nears the close. It's the Aggies and Tigers right now on ESPNU.